Hi, I'm Denise from Four Square Microfarm. Okay, so I'm looking this over and hoping there's not so much junk in the background because I have a lot going on. First of all, a little bit of housekeeping, and you know how I hate videos where people just ramble on, but well, I guess this could be a first. First of all, it's almost Christmas, and so I rotate through crafts. If I haven't said already, I sew, knit, weave, spin, and paint, do a little paper crafting. And so now I'm making Christmas cards, and I'm about at 60. And the thing about the Christmas cards is I was trying to find one design that I could just make over and over again, because it's so much easier when you're making like bulk cards, just make a bunch of the same cards. But what happened was, every time I made a particular card, I kind of had a slightly different idea, and I went off on this tangent, and then I've got all these different style cards, and it just got a little crazy. And so they're not all of them are the same. So I guess that kind of worked out. But then that means I've got like paper. It's just like little bits of paper all over the planet in the room. It's like in the carpet and in the wooden mat and just insane. And then the little puppy Jewel, you know, she grabs the little pieces of paper and runs all over the place with them. But anyway, so I did the paper crafting. And at the moment, I'm trying to make things to go into my Etsy shop, I'm trying the Etsy shop or whatever over again. And so that kind of gets into the middle of what it is I'm actually doing. So I'm making projects for myself. I'm doing projects for the Etsy shop. I'm going to start open myself to trades again for spin for a trade. So it's just kind of busy here. Okay, so let's see. Let's start with the Jacob mitts. I just finished these the other day, and they need to have their ends woven in, and they still feel kind of wet. And this mitt is from a Jacob single that I spun, maybe last year. And it's the singles that go along with the bag. I don't know, I think I did the woven scarf, turned it into a bag thing. And so this is the fan and feather, or is it feather and fan? I can never remember. Put that on so you can see it better, which is like one of my favorite go-to patterns. You don't get to see it, the feather, as clearly as you would with a different item, like the mohair scarf, but it still gives you the nice shaping. And so got a pair of those, and they'll go to somebody. Okay, now, these are the Aileen mitts, and I kind of goofed up on these guys, but, well, it still turned out nice. This is 100% Angora hand spun. And it's a nice cuff. And this is not the same thumb as the Aileen mitts thumb, but this is the thumb from the Owl gloves. And I like the thumb so much, I'm just gonna make it my standard thumb, because the gusset right here is a nice shape, and I don't have to leave stitches and pick them up to finish the thumb. It'd be nice if I had knit the two together in the right spot, then it would have been tighter right here. But that's because the directions for this thumb was meant to be worked individually, and I put them both on the same needle because I prefer to do everything two at a time. So anyway, I can always hem that up, but it's okay with the way it is too. And so this is not the same thumb from the Ellen mitts, but the lace pattern is here. And then I decided to add ribbing across the top so that I can make the glove longer and then fold it back if need be, if it gets in the way. Now it won't fold in front of everybody, right? Okay, anyway, just pretend it folded because I can't really do it that way. So anyway, it's supposed to fold down like this, just in case I need more flexibility on my fingers. Though, I mean, really, what am I going to do in soft Angora gloves? These ones are thinner than my other ones. The other ones are bulkier spin, and I actually shovel snow in them. But these ones are thinner, more elegant, so I'm not going to shovel snow or and do anything in particular with that glove on. So those two are the two mitts. I had a friend who asked me for a pair, and so I was like, well, what am I going to use? And then I went into my stash to see what I had left, and I have all these, like, bags. Look at that. Just bags of yarn. I was like, oh, my goodness. And they're all from weaving projects. And so what I decided I'm going to do is, because she can't use Angora, I'm going to use the Peruvian wool I dyed a little while ago. And so those will turn out nicely. My other option is that I have some really nice black merino sock yarn, and I could use this silver gray as the bottom of the lace part. So I'm thinking I'll probably use this. Or this and over dye. It depends on, I don't know how this would knit up, considering with the variegation. That might be interesting. All right, so these ones are Knit Picks Bear, actually. They're not hand spun like the other ones. I decided I'd try a little dyeing, and so I got some Knit Picks skeins that I dyed up that actually turned out really nicely. Okay, also, I was so much into these muffetees, I made myself a pair from Velvet and a pair of spats to match. And I've decided I'm going to trim these with the lace edging that I knit from the historical lace video. I thought the Angora edging would look kind of cool across the top. Press that out. But there's also several other edgings that could go neatly across there. Okay. All right, that's just some random stuff. Here's what I really want to talk about. This. For work in progress. Talk about the weaving a different day because it's still on loom and I haven't really touched it. I got really busy trying to make stuff for the shop. Okay, so I'm thinking in the Tour de Fleece video, you may have seen this yarn from, I'm not even sure what Tour de Fleece day it was, maybe 17. And I'm not a real big fan of textured art yarns. I'm like a really plain Jane kind of person, and I like to make like just kind of straight, sturdy yarns to weave with and to knit with, just kind of normal monotone, or maybe like natural tone colors, not always like monotone, but I do tend to like the browns, the grays, tans, whites, things like that. So this is some fiber that a friend gave me, and it was already dyed, and it was just crazy fiber, and I was like, well, I'm Tour de Fleece, and I need something to spin, because I spun through all of the Jacob and the Angora I had already prepared. And so I spun this up, and it was crazy, and I decided I didn't want to interrupt the different colors, so I would go ahead and spiral ply, and I love the spiral ply that I do. So I figured if I'm going to spiral ply, I might as well do a thick and thin with the bobbles, because I like how that turned out with the, what was it? It was the alpaca from last year. Love how that turned out. So after I finished, got 147 yards, and I was like, I don't know what in the world I'm going to do with this. And sometimes, depending on, I guess, how you feel, sometimes you spin things, and you're just like, what in the world? Especially if you're doing like I'm doing a lot of experimenting with the different spins and the different textures, and I'm just doing it to enhance my skills. I don't always like what it is I'm spinning. Like, I don't always like coils or beehives or any of that kind of stuff, but I'm spinning to learn the techniques, and it enhances my spinning. So, you know, you do the spin, and you might not like your yarn. You might not like how it turned out, you know, or maybe you're just getting started, and you've got a lot of, like, bobbled yarn, thick and thin yarn that you actually hadn't planned on being thick and thin. You're like, well, what do I do with that? Or maybe you see this incredible skein that's just like insane, thick and thin, chunky stuff falling out of it or whatever, locks dripping off of it, and you're trying to figure out what in the world do I do with it? You know, so I'm looking at the skein, I'm like, first of all, it's green and yellow and green and yellow. I don't even like green and yellow, not those greens anyway. What am I gonna do with this horrible thing? So I decided to go ahead and knit it up. And I always say knitting covers a multitude of sins. It just does. It just transforms your yarn. And so knit with your yarn. Use your yarn. Weave with your yarn. Do something with your yarn. No matter how you feel about it, if you get this yarn and you're just like, I hate this. I don't want this. Use it anyway. And you might be very surprised on how it turns out when you use it. So I'm knitting a cow, and there's no pattern. I just started with 50 stitches, okay? Then I joined it in a round and did a rib, and I started by adding yarn overs every third stitch. So 1, 2, 3 yarn over, 1, 2, 3 yarn over, 1, 2, 3 yarn over. And then a knit, 1 or 2 knit rows, and then yarn over, 1, 2, 3 yarn over, 1, 2, 3 yarn over, every 2 or 3 knit rows. And then at the front and the middle, at the back, and then on the end, well, this would, I guess it would both be the front, I added a make one by knitting front and back. So I added 3 extra, so it would kind of V out at that point on the front and in the back. And then at some point, I'll add the make one, knit front and back on these sides, so it'll begin to V out at those points and turn the cow. And actually, automatically, the moment I began knitting, I loved it. So, you know, just colors just came alive. I am so sorry. The dogs are behind me, and they have decided that this is a great time to play, and they're all in the room with me. All right, so that's just what I wanted to share with you, and hopefully I'll try to stay on schedule and come back again in a few days and do another work in progress.